Hello there, you're once more welcome to the Glory Realm Devotion Moment. God has something beautiful for you today. His plans for us are good and not evil. Plans to bring us to our expected end. And you know, the expected end of the Lord is beautiful one. There is something beautiful among everyone who trusts in the Lord. Bible says, they that put their trust in the Lord shall not be confounded. And that means you shall not be put to shame. Whatever has brought you shame, whatever is bringing you embarrassment, we decree it comes to an end now. This is the moment the glory of God invades your life and everything turns around for good. Hallelujah. Today we want to continue on the study of the book of John, the Gospel of John. Yesterday we ended chapter number 5 to the last verse, you know, verse number 47. And such an amazing opportunity to look into the Word of God. And today we are going into chapter number 6. And chapter number 6 has such beautiful, you know, promises and blessings. Get ready, you're about to have the glory of God invade your life like never before. And chapter number 6, from verse number 1 of chapter number 6, the Word of God says, after this, Jesus went to the farthest side of the Sea of Galilee, that is the Sea of Tiberias. So he left where he was discussing with the Jews and went to the farthest side of the Sea of Galilee, the Sea of Tiberias, you know. And, you know, in the next verse it says, and a great crowd was following him. A great crowd. Now, wherever Jesus shows up, something unusual happened, and it's still happening today. And I'm very confident that something unusual is going to happen to you even on this broadcast. So a great crowd was following because they had seen the signs, that is miracles, which he continually performed upon those who were sick. They had seen. There is something about the power of vision. When people see, there is a stirring up, you know. But you see, we as Christians, those who have, you know, a strong faith in the Lord, you know, we don't need to see before we believe. We believe and then we see. But for those who are just curious, trying to know what this thing is all about, you know, they saw the miracles that Jesus was performing, and you know, the signs and the wonders, how many sick were healed, and suddenly words went round and the multitude began to come. So wherever he shows up, wherever Jesus shows up, there is a crowd. And that's how the crowd developed to become like 5,000 persons that he has to feed. He has to feed. Let's go to the next verse. Verse number 3 tells us this. And Jesus walking up the mountainside and sat down there with his disciples. So looking at the multitude, Matthew has a wonderful way of putting it. He puts it this way. Seeing the multitude, he went up a mountain and sat down and taught them. So whenever the multitude shows up, he wants to have a vintage position, you know, where he can speak and the sound will travel. As I thought about this just before this recording, it occurred to me that he understands, you know, the principle that is involved in the travel of sound. Those of us who studied physics at school have an understanding of the travel of, you know, wavelength of light and wavelength, you know, the wave of sound. And then up a hill, he has this vintage position to be able to speak in such a way that his voice will become amplified somehow, all right? Yeah, we don't have time to go into all the science stuff. So he went up there and started teaching. Now the Passover, the feast of the Jews, was approaching when this incident took place. It was close to the Passover. And don't forget, the Passover has to do with the deliverance of Israel from, you know, from Egypt. And that's what was written about in the book of Exodus, you know, talking about the moving of God's people from bondage into the land of freedom, all right? And so, you know, so the feast was, marked with the slaying of the lamb, the killing of lambs, which was done in Egypt, you know, and the night that was done, the next day They came out as free persons. In fact, in the middle of the night, you know, their freedom was announced and they came out. And so it was close to this very important feast. Verse number 6 says, Jesus looked up then and seeing that a vast multitude was coming toward him, he said to Philip, where are we to buy bread so that all these people may eat? Now, he saw the multitude and thought of feeding them. You know why? They've come from a long way. And if they don't have something to eat, then you may be causing some problem there. He knew that they needed food. That's how caring our Lord is. And he provided food for them. And then the next verse make us realize now, and look at what happened. But he said this to prove, that is to test him, for he well knew what he was about to do. You see, whenever the Lord asks you a question or asks any man a question, it's not because he is ignorant of what to do or looking for solution from man. He just wants to see if we are in sync with his divine agenda. And so when some situation in life bring some, you know, unanswered questions that make you want to kind of question, be careful how you also respond. Or when you see certain people going through certain situation that poses some kind of question, be careful how you respond. Because the Lord already knows what to do. What you are going through today is not a mystery to him. He knows the genesis and he knows how to bring it to an end. So all you just need to do is to listen and follow the leading of the Spirit of God, because he knew well what to do. The next verse revealed to us, you know, some wonderful part of the story. Philip answered him, 200 pennies, and that is $40. $40 worth of bread is not enough that everyone may receive even a little. Another translation say a bite. Can you imagine a multitude? And what is available, not everybody will be able to get a bite. It's amazing how the Lord works. Now let's go to the next verse and I'll show you something as we take this up. The next verse revealed to us in verse number 8, another of his disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, said to him, and then verse 9 says, there is a little boy here who has with him 5 barley loaves. A little boy who has 5 barley loaves and 2 small fish. But what are they among so many people? And this is also amazing. He came up with what looks like the solution, but then he didn't see how God is going to work with what seemed to be nothing. We're going to continue more on this tomorrow, but I want to bring in a lesson here. Sometimes the thing that we look down on is the very thing that the Lord wants to use to bring forth an unusual miracle. The thing that you kind of like disdain is the very thing that he has ordained to bring forth the supernatural. And, you know, we know this story, but I want you to hang in there and continue on this tomorrow. God has something much more. Don't look at it with your own eyes. Don't look at it with your own understanding. Just lay it before the Lord and see what he would do with it. At least Andrew tried. Andrew was able to look for the solution. Philip was kind of like trying to make sense out of what Jesus was trying to ask him to do. But, you know, Andrew went and brought in something. Whatever your situation is, lay it before the Lord and you'll see the glory that will be revealed. I want you to give him everything, your body, your soul, and your spirit, and you will see what he will do with your life. Thank you for being part of today's broadcast. It has been a great joy coming across to you. I pray that the Lord will bless you, keep you, cause his hand to be mighty upon you, and cause your testimony to manifest in due season. Till I come your way again tomorrow, by the grace of God, I'm Igho Yegbeburu. God bless you.